This is the Redeemed Christian Church of God, Covenant Chapel, a place where destinies are redeemed and dominion is restored. May God bless you as you listen.
Well, with respect to pathway to victories and accomplishments, we've been looking at, as a case study, the life of a lady that is called Hannah. And one thing that is a constant in life, you know, for a life that wants to do well, for a life of attainment, you don't run away from troubles, because it's a constant about life. There will be challenges. So problems, provocations, they are constants in the pathway of life, in the pathway to victory. And when you begin to face it, you know, you will get a promise. The prayer is talking about facing it. Facing it. And today we want to round off by looking at provision and performance. After you get the promise, there will be provision. And plus provision, there will be performance. Praise God. Well, it's important that I mention to you that in life, provision follows performance. Provision follows performance. For anything that you want in life, there is something that you need to do. Performance. Before you get what you want, provision. You always need to do something. So you can call provision and performance twins. Because when you are asking God to provide something for you, many a times he's asking you, what are you ready to perform? What are you ready to perform? When you are asking God for fruit, he's asking you for seed. Because without a seed, there cannot be a fruit. Provision and performance. God wants to see what you will do with what he will give to you. When you look at the prayer of, what's her name, Hannah, in 1 Samuel chapter 1, verse 11, 1 Samuel chapter 1, verse 11, you see a couple of things there. She said, Lord, look upon my affliction. When you look upon my affliction, you know, remember me, don't forget me. Specific, give me a son. When you give me this son, I will give this son back to you. And God became so excited. God wants to see what we will do with what he will give to us. God always wants to see what you will do with what he will give to you. That is when he becomes so excited. He always wants to see what you will do. It is very, very important to him. Extremely important to him. When you go to the Bible passage, please go back to the first slide. In 1 Samuel chapter 1, the Bible tells us that in the process of time, one of the reasons why we get what we do not ask for is because we don't follow the process of time. Time is an equal opportunity employer. Time. Every man, every woman is given 24 hours in a day, whether rich or otherwise. in the process of time. So you can say time is a manufacturer. Time is a processor. But it is what you give to time that time gives back to you. At a time in the life of Hannah, Hannah was giving weeping to time. And she was getting back affliction. But the moment she changed her approach, she decided to knock on the door of God. She decided to bear her heart out. She decided to say what she wanted. Time gave her back a son. Time will not process apple and give you orange. It is what you spend time with that you are able to win in. If you don't spend time in what you want, you don't get the right product. The Bible calls us the light of the world. What light doesn't touch remains in darkness. Maybe one of the reasons why some areas of our lives are in darkness is that our light is not touching that area. Wherever light touches, darkness, because light does not negotiate with darkness. The dominion of light over darkness is always instant. Praise God. Praise the living Jesus. Don't use your frustration, or don't let your affliction process frustration. Use your affliction as a fuel to get favor from God. The moment Hannah changed her approach, she got what she wanted. But many a times, process of time, in our lives, what do? We turn our challenges to idols. We start worshiping our challenges. We don't see God in the midst of our difficulties. But Hannah decided that, listen, enough is enough. Enough is enough. It's time that I begin to see God. What you are given in the process of time is meant to be utilized, not to be hoarded. Those are the things that makes God to do what? To hearken to your cry. Hannah said, if you give me back this child. This is always the cycle with God. This is the cycle with God. Hannah got Samuel, and Samuel was given back to God. What God gives to you, or even what God has given to you now, what are you doing with it? Some of us, we ask God, God, give me a job. But what do you do with the job? God, give me a car. What do you do with the car? God, give me a wife. What do you do with your wife? Oh, let me, or a husband. Let me go there a little bit. You know, when you ask God for victories, accomplishments, he wants to know what you will do with it. The purpose of whatever you are seeking from him must always be right. Process of time. Let me talk about it a little bit. A man of God said something. He said, listen, even if you have a dog, the dog needs your time. You now have a husband, you now have a wife. You don't want to spend time with with him or her. A dog needs your time, not to talk of a human. So if what you are getting from your husband or wife is not what you thought you would get, maybe it's because your light is not shining into her, or your light is not shining to him. Maybe that is the reason why some areas in the relationship, they are dark. Because time is not being spent there. How do you get provision from God? How do you get what you desire from God? You need to utilize what he has already given to you. Because there's treasure in you as a child of God. A man by the name Charles Spurgeon said something. Can you show Charles Spurgeon? You know, because it's not just knowing. It's not just having knowledge. It's what you do with it. What you do with it. You know, he said, wisdom is the right use of knowledge. To know is not to be wise. Many men, they know a great deal and are all the greater fools for it. There is no fool so great a fool as a knowing fool. But to know how to use knowledge is to have wisdom. God always wants to see what you will do with what he has given to you. And I pray that you will always do what is right. You will always do what is glorious. You will always do what is marvelous. In the mighty name of Jesus. How do you get what you want from God? What you see in the midst of your difficulties, in the midst of your challenge, is very, very important to God. The guys working it are fast forwarded. You know, how to activate provision. You know, I'm going to just run through this. One of the first things is what you see. What you see. Why what you see is very important. What you don't see is also very, very important. Please note that. In the midst of your challenges, in the midst of your difficulties, what are you seeing? Many people, no matter what is going on, they never see God in the midst of their challenges. They don't see God in the midst of your challenges. But God, you should know something about God. If God can see you, he can see your problem. If he can see your problem, I'm telling you, he can do something about your problem. One of the first things we need to recognize on the pathway to victory is the fact that God is not a wicked God. When you realize that God is not a wicked God, the solution to whatever you are facing, it will appear to you. But when you are thinking that, is God punishing me for what I did thousands of years ago? What you did thousands of years ago. You are just 30 years old. Let me share with you a story. Let's take some studies. I learned something from a man of God. I was sharing with my wife yesterday. I said, this man is a very profound man. I love the way he thinks because I love thinkers. He shared a story in the month of January at a conference in Washington, D.C. He said he was in Ghana. He was in a boat. They were on the Volta River. He had a baseball cap on. And as the boat was going, the wind blew. It blew off the cap. And he said, oh, let's forget about it. Another person in the boat said, because tour guide, the person driving the boat, felt that, oh, we owe you. Said, when we get to the hotel, there are some shops that sell, we will get buy you another one. But the person driving the boat said, I will turn back. And he said, why do you want to turn back? It's just a baseball car. I said, I will turn back so that I will do something. I will show you my diving skills. I will turn back so that I will do what? I will show you my diving skills. Listen, provision. When many of us see problems, a few see a platform. In the time of challenges, the first thing that lots of people see is problem. But the few that will be victorious, they see a platform. A platform to display all that God has been depositing in them. In the time of crisis, in the time of challenges, what do you see? What do you see? This is very, very critical and important to your victories in life. What you see. That boy said, I will turn back and I will show you how good I can dive. In life, it's not about the things that we face, but what we do when we face the challenges. Anybody that wants to be victorious knows how to face challenges. David was going towards Goliath. He was running towards him, not running away from him. Use your affliction to be the fuel to chase after, to overcome the difficulty that is facing you. Let that affliction be a fuel to be an overcomer. And by the mercy of God, you will overcome. Amen. By the grace of the Most High God, you will overcome. Amen. In the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Understand something, you will see. In life, the solution that one man profess for a problem may not be the same solution that you will profess. One person said, let us turn back. One person said, we will buy another one. One person said, it doesn't matter. Because in life, you are not at the same level. In life, you don't have the same resources. And in life, you don't see things the same way. When one person decides to dive into the ocean, don't dive into the ocean with that person. If you don't have the skills to do what? To swim. Praise God. The person that said it doesn't matter, the person had resources to buy 2,000 caps if he wants to buy 2,000 caps. But if it matters to you, you need to turn back. If it matters to you, you need to turn back. But listen. Look at the man that said, let us turn back. Because the baseball cap may be the most expensive in this currency, let's say $100. I don't know how much they sell it. Maybe it's $100. In the grand scheme of life, how much is $100? But that guy did not turn back because of the cost or the worth of the baseball cap, but because there's an audience. Many a times, the problem that will come your way praise God, hear this, don't miss this. The problem that will come your way will present you a platform to show what you want to do. So don't miss it. It will be a platform for you to show that I can do this. People they have not known before in your office that you can do this. But the problem arises, though you are not going to be paid for it, but it is a platform for everybody to know that you have this ability. You have the ability. God is not going to knock on your door and say that, listen, go and do it. It is for you to recognize and seize the moment. Because he has been preparing you for such a time as this. The challenges that you've been facing, they've been preparing you for such a time as this. The difficulties that you are now facing is a platform for you to exhibit the gifts of God in you. And the gift of God, it does what? It makes room. The gift of God will make room for you. The gift of the Almighty God will make room for you. In the mighty name of Jesus, you will not be backward. I say your destiny will not be backward. When you make good thinking a possibility, you make godly placement a priority in life. Provision. Hannah had been going to Shiloh years and years and years and years until she started thinking that, wait a minute, the purpose for my coming here, I've never even tried it. I've not done it. And that is the way some people behave in life. They major on the minor. They allow things to distract them from where they are supposed to get to. What are the things distracting you? Hear this. You could be asking God for blessing, but God could bring to you a problem. The blessing is in the problem. You could be asking God, God bless me. And he knows that giving you something will not take you, that this problem, when you solve it, where it will take you, it will be monumental. Realize that when you are trying to, let me explain it. I remember at the time, the general overseer of the Redeemed Christian Church of God said somebody came to him and he said, I want to be a sponsor of some of the programs of RCCG. You know, and he prayed for him, God, do this for this man. And this guy was a salary earner. And maybe that same week or thereabout, he lost his job. And he came back crying and said, I just prayed, I want to be sponsoring, and this is what happened, I lost my job, how am I going to do it? He said he laughed. He said, with what you are earning, is that what you are going to sponsor? You know, God presented with him a problem. So that response, he had something in him. It brought about the entrepreneurial ability in him. There is something in you that God wants to bring out. God, bless me. And all of a sudden, you have not done anything wrong. A problem comes. Know that the blessing is in the problem. The blessing of Hannah was in the problem. Because she finally had a son that is more than 10 sons. Many a times, the blessing that you will eventually get will be because of how you face the problem that you encounter. So if you've not been getting the results, check how you've been dealing with the problem. Praise God. Praise the living Jesus. Listen. let me take some things that I learned from that conference a little bit, you know, before I go in another direction, you know. That man, he lost his cap. Some of us, look at it. Because we lose our cap, we lose our vision. But what can a cap actually cover in life? Maybe you have not lost a cap. Maybe you have lost something. Because of the something that you have lost, some of us will lose our vision. Hear me. They were in a boat. Current was moving them, going forward. Engine in the boat, going forward. Some of us, we turn back in the current of God to chase after what is insignificant. God is taking us, moving us forward. Somebody said, shut up. We turn back to face shut up when God is moving us forward. What is insignificant, we chase it. And you said, success, accomplishments, it follows performance. What you are doing, because remember, I said, time, in the process, Hannah went through certain things, and he realized that time seems to be giving me the wrong thing. I need to change what I'm giving to time, so that time can give me what is right. In the process of time, I said, is a processor. If you are not getting the right things from time, check what you are giving to time. Praise God. Praise the victories and accomplishments. Hear this. I was studying at the time. I read the story of a salesman. I read the story of a salesman. And what happened? There was an advert. They wanted salesmen. A big company. And it was just oral interview they had. And this guy really impressed. Though they sent him to the field. And he went to the field. But when he made the first sales, he sent an email back to his manager. And the writing was, you know, I'm done. Just a very terrible English. And the manager said, wow, I employed an illiterate. While he was thinking, how do I solve this problem? This man sent another email, you know, a few hours later that, I've done another sales and I've netted in over $1 million. And the guy said, wait a minute, what do I do? Because it is what I sent him to do that he's doing. So as a good manager, he escalated to the director. And the director pondered over it. And the director called a meeting of salesmen and put something on the notice board. He said, it is high time we begin to sell and not spell. Is that the spelling? That's not the spelling of selling. Praise God. You know, in life, how you think, you know, I have something. I thought we would put this on different slides. You know, human beings may try to put you down. Just rise up. Don't focus on this, that. Let your performance show, and the provision will follow. What is called an inability, use it for your own good. In the pathway of life, listen. When you see certain people running, pursuing after something. They are running because you can't see some things that is pursuing them. Praise God. Maybe reproach is pursuing them. Maybe they've been reproaching you. Praise God. Use the reproach to do what? To chase after your destiny. Maybe they've been saying that you useless person. Use that you useless person to do what? To chase after your destiny. Time will tell. In the process of time, who is useless will show forth. Go back. In the process of time, Hannah had what? He had Samuel. In the process of time, you will have your Samuel. When you know how to process time. So maybe the reason why you've not been having the right success is because you have not been processing time accurately. You have not been processing time correctly. In the process of time, when you understand what you need to do, praise God. Let's rise up on our feet. Lord God Almighty, we bless you. Lord God Almighty, we worship you. Thank you, King of Kings. Thank you, Lord of Lords. Thank you, Ancient of Days. Thank you, Most High God. Almighty Father, we thank you. King of, I want you to open, this is the last Sunday. I want you to open your mouth to begin to thank God. Thank him that he is taking you even from the first day of the month to this day. Please, the technical team, if you can show me the prayer points from Friday, that would be very good. Because I want us to be able to take three out of it. If you can please have it from my slides of Friday. Praise the Lord. Praise the living Jesus. Listen, I've taught you something from the beginning of this month. I looked at it critically. And what is it? I said, you mean what you say. Praise God. That is one of the reasons why we display a couple of things. Because no murmurer gets anything from God. When you say it, you mean it. Did you hear me? When you say it, you do what? You mean it. Praise God. No, the first one. This is about the last few ones. The first one. Start from the first one. Praise God. The first favor sealer. Take the first favor sealer for us. You know. Yes. In 2 Peter chapter 1 verse 17, the Bible says, Jesus Christ received from God the Father honor and glory. When such a voice came to him from excellent glory, he said, this is my beloved son, in whom I am well pleased. Praise God. The voice of God can announce your destiny. Because when God speaks, animate and inanimate objects, they hear him. Living and the dead, they hear him. The ground, they hear him. The water hears him. The wind hears him. So when he announces that this is my favored daughter, the ground that you walk upon will begin to favor you. The water you drink begins to favor you. The air you breathe begins to favor you. So that is why you are going to pray. Say, Almighty Father, baptize my destiny with favor by your voice of excellent glory. I want you to pray that prayer. Baptize my destiny with favor by your voice. Let your voice announce me. Let your voice announce me. Let your voice announce me. Most High God, Almighty Father, the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, the Ancient of Days, the Lion of the tribe of Judah, Lord Most High, Lord Most High. Don't mumble. You have the prayer there to read it. God wants to hear your voice, that you really mean it. In Jesus' name. The second one now, quickly. In Isaiah chapter 45, verse 1, God told a heathen, not a believer like yourself, an unbeliever, he said, this is what the Lord says, and he called him his anointed. He said he was holding his right hand to subdue nations, to open the loins of kings, to disarm them, to open doors before him, doors of favor, doors of victory, doors of accomplishment, and the doors will never be shut. That is everlasting victory. That is why you're going to pray to God. Say, Almighty Father, hold me by the hand so that I will always walk into favor. Almighty Father, hold me by the hand so that I will always walk into favor. Almighty Father, hold me by the hand so that I will always walk into favor. Almighty Father, hold me by the hand so that I will always walk into favor. Hold me by the hand. Almighty Father, hold me by the hand so that I will always walk into favor. King of glory, hold me by the hand so that I will always walk into favor. King of kings, hold me by the hand so that I will always walk into favor. Yes, Lord. Hold me by the hand. Let me always walk into favor. Hold me by the hand. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. We have two more quickly. The next one. Hey, I love this. 2 Samuel 12:25. This was God speaking to David after he had an affair with Bathsheba. The boy died, but later on, he had another son. And the Bible says, the Lord loved the child and sent word through Nathan, the prophet, that they should name him Jedidiah, which means beloved of the Lord, as the Lord had commanded. Let me quickly give you a nugget. You know, the one that brought news that made you sad, God can use him to bring news that will make you to rejoice. Remember that. Nathan was the one that brought news that said you messed up. He's the one that also brought news that says God is pleased with you. Praise God. That God is telling me something right now. By the mercy of God in this week, that place where you had problem, in the very same place, God will make you a success. In the mighty name of Jesus. We want to cry to heaven and say, Almighty Father. Jedidiah means the beloved of God. No beloved of God can lack any good thing. So have that understanding. Now we take it again. Almighty Father. Your beloved cannot lack any good thing. Announce me as your beloved. Announce me as your beloved. Announce me as your beloved. Turn into prayer. As your beloved, I cannot lack any good thing. Announce me as your beloved. Announce me as your beloved. As your beloved, I cannot lack any good thing. Announce me as your beloved. Announce me as your beloved. Almighty Father, as your beloved, I cannot lack any good thing. Announce me as your beloved. In Jesus' name. The last one. The Bible says, we know the story very well. Harlot, Rahab the harlot. Look at it. Hebrews 11:31 says, by faith. The Bible could have said by faith, Rahab did not perish. But the Bible says by faith, the harlot Rahab did not perish with those who did not believe. When she had received the spies with peace. What is the prayer there? You are going to cry to Almighty God. Say, Almighty Father.
Almighty Father.
irrespective of my background. Help me to take steps of faith with courage so that your faith will set me apart. So that your favor will set me apart. So that your favor will set me apart. Almighty Father, irrespective of my background, help me to take steps of faith with courage so that your favor will set me apart. Help me to take steps of faith with courage so that your favor will set me apart. Help me to take steps of faith with courage. Father, let me take steps of faith with courage so that your favor will set me apart. Help me to take steps of faith with courage so that your favor will set me apart. Thank you, Most High God. In Jesus' name. Put your hands on your head. Father, we thank you. Most High God, we praise you. Lord Jesus, this is the last Sunday in this fifth month. My Father, my God, Most High God, Most High God, make these destinies victorious. In the remaining days of this month, let them be days of victories. Let them be days of accomplishments. In the mighty name of Jesus. Lord God, let your children begin to see the problem as a platform for victory. Father, what caused them difficulties? Father, let that same thing make their destiny distinct. As you gave me authority, I speak into the destinies of your children. I say, begin to eat the good of this land. I say, begin to eat the good of this land. I say, begin to eat the good of this land. Thank you, Most High. In Jesus' name.
Thank you for joining us today. We hope you have been richly blessed.
Please join us same time next week as we dig deeper into the Word of God.